The theme is about games. So I always love to play games, and I've been playing games when I was little kid. Today we are going to talk about not just like video games that I like and I work in this field, but I will talk about different type of games, which is just not the game about digital games, but it's a game about which is we are going to talk about the games which is more about other things than the game. So let's talk about what is a game. A game is actually comprised of some set of rules and some strategy, and there are some players who make some decisions and make some strategies, and then there are outcomes according to each and every strategy. So we have players, we have strategies, we have rules, and we have outcomes. And what are the outcomes? One, win and lose, zeros and ones. Mostly, when we define winning, we automatically imply that someone is losing, right? A lot of people does that. So somebody is losing. But do you think there can be any other outcome?
Yes.
Well, draws. There can be a lot of outcomes. And today we are going to talk about those outcomes, like how these outcomes are different and how they impact our lives. So first of all, raise your hands if you play games. Everybody plays games, that's really cool. But even if you don't play games, some of you who did not raise hands, the thing about video games are not just like, I'm not talking about just video games. We all play games, whether we want or not. So let's see. The game of life. So today we are going to talk about it. What is it? It starts when we go to schools. It's about like, you know, getting first grades, getting medals, getting trophies, getting admission in the best university, getting best job and the best company, and you know, proving ourselves that we are best in everything, right? That's the game of our lives. And that's what we do. And this is where we induce a competitive behavior in ourselves. This is where we tell ourselves that we have to win and we have to get a first position, right? So today I'm going to talk about that, how this behavior impacts our life. So what about if we don't want to compete? If we don't want to compete, we don't want to win, we don't want to lose. If we don't want to compete, does that mean we are losing? So today I'm going to talk about the story of not winning. It's the story of my life, and it started when I went to school. I lived my life in a very competitive environment, and I saw everybody around me buried themselves in the books, assignments, and tried to win get the first grades in there. But I didn't want to be the part of that competition. I didn't want to win the race. I didn't want to know what it's, I don't know if somebody knows that, the experience or having the feeling inside you when you are studying books, but you don't really know that if you're going to get a first grade or second grade, like first position or second position, but you just don't care. I wanted to learn the wonders inside the books and specifically read the pages which has pictures on it. It would attract me the most. And that was my objective when I was in the school. And I had a feeling I was not the part of the race that was going on there. So what happened? So I want to talk about how did I spend my childhood. I was playing games in the arcade. I would sneak with my brothers into the gaming arcade, and I was playing games with them, and I was having fun. I was playing cricket in the street with my friends and with my brothers and my siblings all the time, and I would not care if I would ever get an A grade or B grade or F grade in any exam, and I would just study whatever it like made me interested. And I was also quitting school at the age of 30. I quit my school. Now you all must wonder why. So what happens when I was playing games in arcades, my love for video games increased and it went into computer. And when I saw that magic machine, I was like, oh my God, this is wonderful. Like, you know, the characters are moving, jumping, what's happening? Like, I want to understand what's going on in this machine. And I wanted to study computer science. But unfortunately, I was studying in a public school. And my entire school, there was only one computer, which was the decoration piece in the library. It was not working. So that was the decorative. I went to my principal. And I talked to her like, you know, I want to study computer science. If you can let me, study computer science. So she gave me two options. Either I study whatever it is there in the school or leave the school. I left the school. I went home and I told my parent, like, I've left the school. The moment when everybody in Pakistan, they are preparing to win the game of board exam of ninth grade, I quit the school. I was not there to win. I was like, I'm not going to school. My parents were so freaked out. They told me that, what did I do? Nobody's going to take you in this college right now. It's the middle of like ninth grade. It's board exam, this and that. All the hype we created, like, it's your board exam. You should study the board exam, all the horror that we get all the time. But I did get admission. I gave the test to the most of the model colleges in Islamabad, and I got the admission in the exact school where I wanted, an exact class where I wanted to study computer science. And I started coding when I was 13 years old to explore the wonders of the magical machine called computers. But that journey of finding that magic and how that magical character moves on the screen is very long. Every time I level up in my game, the game kept getting difficult. Every new mission was difficult. Every new step was difficult than that. So I started in my college from public to private. It was a huge financial burden for my parents. So I had to do some part-time work, sometimes tuition, some other work to earn some money. It was difficult, and it was difficult in the other part. When we moved from a public to private sector, there's a huge change in the lot of people's behaviors. I was not, like, my English was not good. I had a very poor English as compared to other kids. My shoes were not shining. My clothes were not shining. I was not like them. They had a different kind of race. They had a different kind of competitions with them. And I was not there. I was not there for the competition. I really wanted to learn. And I only sit in the library all day and study whatever I wanted to. Time passed quickly, and I came out of college, and I was ready to go to the university. The university was the biggest challenge and the biggest mission of my life. And with the amount of coins that I had in my pocket, it was difficult. So, and that's where the game of my life gave me a biggest bonus, a fully funded scholarship for the university, and achievement unlocked. I got fully funded scholarship for my university, and that was the most happiest day of my life. But I did not stop playing games. My attitude was the same. I played more games. In fact, I started organizing gaming tournaments in the university with my friends. And I used to be the only girl. Imagine the room full of this, like, full boys, and there was only one girl, like, who's organizing tournament, telling them, oh, what you have to do, or is it stuff like that. So, and all my university life, I went on adventures, I went on hiking, I went on a lot of, and I had a lot of fun with my friends. I was happy. I was studying my favorite subjects, computer graphics, animations, AI, and games. And I was an average student, and I was happy. I loved it. Then, during my studies, I started experimenting with text-based games. You know, there's like, you know, console-based games, and then I started making some, you know, very, like, some upgraded games later in my semesters. And then one thing that changed my life was my final year project. I made a game for cancer patients to motivate them to fight their disease within their body. That game made a huge impact in my life while I was designing that game, because there was no win or lose in that game. because that might demotivate the cancer patients from playing that game. And it's very difficult for them to have that kind of feelings while they are in such situation. And knowing that there can be a lot of other outcomes, knowing that there can be a lot of other impacts that we can make with games, changed my life and changed my perspective towards video games. And I made that game and I was ready to show the world about my most amazing game. Yeah, the external hard drive where I put my game got corrupted. I lost my all data. I never found that game again, but of course I passed my final year project and my final like bachelor's degree. So the point is, sometimes even the game is going really well, you know, our strategies can change, things can change, and outcomes can change as well. So, back in university, when I was organizing all these gaming tournaments with my friends in university, where you see I was the only girl. So, I saw that a lot of people who comes to play these games in the gaming tournament, they become very competitive and they become very aggressive and then they become very sad if they lose the game. And I don't understand, like really, if one must have to like win the game to enjoy the game, and what is this kind of thing? So you know, one of the best games that I really like but I never won is chess. I learned it from my friends in the university. I've been playing since then. I never won it once. But I love the every single experience of playing that game. Every time I play that game, I love it. Even though I didn't win it. It's not about winning, right? And one of the games I started playing, my husband's favorite game, Dota 2, I started playing it with him. I loved the game overall. But the problem was my husband would get so competitive and he would get so angry when every time I just like, you know, make them lose their game. And he would not want me to be in their team. It's like, oh, you maybe want to play a bot match? Don't play with us. And I could not enjoy playing with him because I'm not the person who will flip the, you know, Ludo board when she will feel like that she's like losing the game. I do not flip the Ludo board. I'm not that person. So I know you, the people who are laughing must have done then all these things. So then there was many level ups, and then finally I graduated and I joined the industry. I started working as a software engineer because by the time I graduated, I found no game studio willing to take me in there, you know, willing to work with them. And there wasn't much game studios in Pakistan either. So I started working as a software engineer, I worked as 1.5 years. That was the most boring experience of my life that I ever had. And I could not continue it. I was like, oh my God, what I'm doing? I quit my job as a software engineer and started making my own games. With the poor experience and the poor knowledge of making games, I've made a lot of failed projects at that time. And I could not survive. But that day, then I replayed my mission with a different role. I started working in game studio, actual game studio. And I was so happy, like, oh my God, now I'm at the place where I actually really wanted to be. I'm working in the game studio, I will be making my game. But the problem was, my team was not cooperating with me. I felt like the mission was different from me. The mission was to sit late hours, make, you know, extra effort to work, make the boss happy, become the best employee, get pay raise, get bonuses, and also push other people down to step up the ladder. That was not my mission. I just wanted to make my own games and learn about that. And then I realized, oh no, I'm in the wrong mission. That was not my mission. So I quit my mission. I quit that job. The ultimate fight of our life, the ultimate level that we play in our life, is actually the fear of losing. That is the boss fight that we fight every day. Many of us do not even want to play a game if they know the opponent is more experienced than them, because they already assume that we are going to lose. That fear is induced in us so badly that we don't want to try. We don't really get up and, you know, try new things. and we don't really try or play any game for experience. So, the game is life. It's just like the game, any other game. We have some players, it can be you and me. We have some challenges, we have some strategies, we have some rewards, and we have some punishments and some outcomes. So what are the outcomes? Win or lose? No. The outcomes are infinite. The outcomes are in terms of learning and experiences. There are so many outcomes that we don't see. And the outcome of every game depends on the player. What kind of player are you? Are you playing to win? Or are you playing for learning and experience? Why are you playing your game for? Why are you playing the game? And this attitude changes everything. This attitude changed everything in me as well. You see that everyone in this room, everyone in around you is actually playing a different mission. Their mission, their skills, their game is different. Your mission is different from them. You have to play to become a better player at your game, not with the, to win or not to compete with other people. So this should be the goal of your life. This should be the goal of your game, the Lad Games Academy. Throughout my experience of my life, when I see the competitive environment in education, in industry, and everywhere, which did not let me learn anything. Because if I want to learn something, I will spend some time on that, and the other people will compete with me, and they try to just like push me back and go ahead. There was a race going on everywhere. So I started this academy to establish collaboration instead of competition. So I designed collaborative learning experience for the future game developers of Pakistan. So they learn the creativity by working with each other with the collaboration. There is no exams, there is no quizzes, there is nothing in my academy. It's a program where you enroll yourself, all the artists, programmers, developers, designers, any creative person, writers, they all work together on one project and they learn about their field and they learn how they can bring more creative ideas to this field and this game industry. And that's my goal where I want to achieve with my collaborative learning experience at Pixel Art Games Academy. I want to give a little bit of example of one of the events that I organized. These are called gaming hackathons and it's called Game Jam. These are hackathons usually comprise of 1 or 2 days and or maximum 3 days, and in 3 days all of the teams they sit together and they make game on one thing, only one thing. And one of these hackathon, it's a global hackathon and it happens all around the world. So the entire world is making games on one thing. And you know what? There is no prize. There is no winning prize. None of my events ever had a winning prize or any winning game or any winning project. The reason is the mantra of having a hackathon is actually bring more innovative and creative ideas. But when you put a prize and a competition, a winning prize, everybody think about just to win the prize. Everybody is thinking, we'll just focus, we have to win, and how we can win. And their efforts will be towards winning, not to bring the creative ideas. And this is one thing that is missing everywhere. We promote winning, we induce winning, we induce competition, not collaboration. And if we induce collaboration, so this is the picture of my game jam where people are collaborating, and this is the face of people who has to give a presentation in 2 minutes to win the competition. So this is how it's different, because the people who are there to collaborate, they learn from each other, they share ideas, they share knowledge, they learn from the collective knowledge of everyone. And they bring creative ideas, they share their ideas, they're not afraid to talk to each other because the other team might steal my idea and win the prize. So this is the difference between hackathons and the game jams that we do and the events that other people does. So this is just an example. And if we replace competition with collaboration, that is going to change everything. The impact of these kind of events, the impact of practicing collaboration instead of competition, is going to change the entire perspective of learning in our lives. So, since I'm ending my talk, I want to talk about one thing that is very particularly about, I want to tell. The games itself are not competition. Be it's a life, a game of your life, be it's a video game, or be it's any game. We have this competitive behavior induced on ourselves from the day when we are born, that makes them competition. And that's the change of our behavior are going to make us a better person, a better learning, and we can give a better learning environment. So I have a request. Today, when we leave this room, every one of yourself, you should ask yourself, so what kind of player are you? So this is the end of my talk, and I want to play a video of one of the very beautiful experience, a beautiful game that I like, and it may give you a very beautiful experience during the end of my talk. And thank you so much.